We are back on SmackDown, the WWE Champion JBL in the ring, set for the debate with John Cena.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you the man that will be challenging JBL in just 10 days. Ladies and gentlemen, John Cena!
Well, this is an unenviable position for the number one contender, John Cena, here tonight. John Cena must keep his cool. John Cena cannot lose his temper if he strikes the champion, JBL. If there's any physicality here tonight, John Cena will lose his title opportunity at WrestleMania.
And JBL is very well aware of that, Cole. You can look for JBL to taunt John Cena, as we saw last week on SmackDown. John Cena, this credit, almost snapped, almost cracked.
Hold on. Now, Teddy Long, I want you to explain to him the rules you made last week are still in effect. If you touch me, you low-life SOB, you lose your chance to face me at WrestleMania. Tell him, Teddy. Tell him.
That's right, JBL. Now, Cena, if you lay a hand on JBL, you will lose your opportunity to face JBL for the WWE Championship at WrestleMania.
That's not fair.
But however, JBL, if you physically provoke John Cena, then he has the right to retaliate.
Now that is fair.
Wow. Now what that means, if you strike John Cena, then John Cena can strike back. You feel me? So it is time for the debate. Now there are three questions. And the first question is for you, JBL. Now, what makes you believe you're more qualified to be the WWE champion?
First of all, Theodore, I would like to thank you. And I would like to thank all of SmackDown. And I would like to thank all of the great fans right here in Memphis, Tennessee, for holding this debate. Go Grizzlies! And I would like to answer the question, what makes me deserve to be a champion more than my opponent, John Cena? You see, America needs heroes, and I have filled that role. I have vanquished all my opponents, and I have become stronger by doing it. I am the ideal American success story from a great family, independently wealthy, from a great spoil. I am a reason for all you people to look up to SmackDown because of me. And I understand there's a champion on the other show that says that he is a 10-time world champion. What that means to me is he lost 9 times. I am the only champion in the history of professional wrestling that has never lost this championship. I have held this championship longer than anybody in over 10 years, including that same guy on the other show. That, Teddy Long, is why I deserve and why I am what I say I am, a wrestling god.
John Cena, same question.
Before I can even answer that question, what makes me more qualified to be champ, I got to turn that back around you, because you some sort of wrestling god. I mean, you're the champ now. You've been champ for quite a long time. Always, you're independently wealthy, a huge success story. Why would someone as successful as you drive to the ring in a broke down limousine?
You know what?
Why?
There's nothing wrong with that limousine.
Hey, man, hey, don't sugarcoat it. Let's go take a look. I mean, first things first, homie.
Oh, whoa.
Daddy, look what he did to my car!
You got a flat tire. You the champ. How you going to ride out here in a limo with a flat tire, man?
That is vandalism. You should be thrown in jail. Daddy Long, do something about this. You're the general manager.
Hey, he's not touching you. He hasn't laid a hand on you.
I'm just... I'm just stating the facts, player. And the paint job, man. What's up with the paint job? Come out in this busted limo with the flat tire and the scuffed up paint. I can't believe you didn't catch that.
There's nothing wrong with that paint job, Cena.
No, man. You ain't looking at it right.
Oh, no.
You see, when I look at it.
Oh, my God. No.
What is wrong with you?
See a limo that says JBL sucks. JBL sucks. Dude, JBL is you. You drove out here in a limo that says JBL sucks.
That's what a $200,000 car.
You know. You know, between that limo fiasco and this hostile crowd here in Memphis, if I was you, I'd just do something about that.
You better show me some respect.
You gonna hit me?
JBL.
You gonna hit me? You gonna do something? Come on, throw a punch.
Hey,
throw a punch here, Big Daddy, come on.
You can do something if you want to.
I'm ready for the next question.
Well, then let's move on.
JBL's holding us cool.
How important is one's social and economic upbringing in being a champion?
Apparently it's real damn important. Look at what that criminal just did to my car. You see, there's a reason that punk criminals like him, the only way he makes it in a car is if you drive me. There's a reason that people like you are kept down by the rich, because that's what's better for America. You mock what you don't understand, and flat honestly, you're jealous, because the only way you know you'll have money like me is if you win the lottery or you turn to crime. So I tell you what, at WrestleMania, I'm going to turn to crime too. I'm going to rob you of your dreams. I'm going to rob you of your hopes. And I'm going to rob you of your dignity when I make you, Cena, bow down and worship at the feet of a wrestling god.
John Cena, you're up, player.
Sounds like somebody crapped in your Cheerios this morning, homie. But, you got a point. I mean, this whole economic thing, maybe I just lost my head. I guess what you're trying to say is I got no respect for, you know, the championship.
You got no class.
I got no class. I mean, look at how I'm dressed. I guess. I mean, I think I'm doing all right. Are we good or what? But, don't go with your panties in a bunch. There are some people who think that we should act a certain way, that we should dress a certain way. So I'm a man of peace. I mean, we can probably solve all this if I just wore a suit and tie, right?
You would look a lot better in a tie. Right now, you look like a piece of crap.
Well, let me see. I'd look better in a tie. Let's just see if that works.
Hey, 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 Teddy, you can't touch me. You, WrestleMania, you look.
Oh, no.
So a tie would look better, huh? Oh, no. I feel like a banker in this. This still sucks. Oh, but, oh, dog. That was yours. And after the car thing, whew, and the tie, you're probably pretty mad right now, huh? You probably want to do something, don't you? Maybe throw a punch? Maybe hit me? If I hit you, I can't go to WrestleMania, but then again, I'm not the one looking like a total jerk, so maybe, you know, maybe you want to do something about it. Maybe you want to throw a punch.
No, I'm not playing your games. You do not outthink the master. At WrestleMania, you will have all you want. But until then, son, play your stupid games.
John Cena, the next question is for you. Now, I want to ask you this, player. What do you need?
What do I need to do to get this punk over here to swing at me? Well, now that's an important question. And one I think we need to address. What if right here, right now, I prove the wrestling god, the champion of champions, a man of class, JBL to be nothing but a liar?
I don't lie.
Hey, have faith in your boy. I can pull it off. Now, Monsignor Theodore Long, watch closely. Because I'm not going to touch you, dog.
You better not touch me.
But I am going to touch your 10-gallon hat. Oh, no, this is nice, dude. This ain't exactly my style or nothing, but I mean, you can tell the craftsmanship. Everything is there. Is this Gucci?
It's $1,000 Stetson.
Okay, then we know that this is probably a 10-gallon hat, right?
I hate you. I hate you, you.
I'll take that as a yes, 10-gallon hat. Well, let's do something. Let's see how many gallons this hat's gonna hold.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
It's $1,000 hat.
Oh, my God.
He's not touching you.
Dude, that ain't even close to like 1 gallon. That means your ass is a liar. Oh, yeah, by the way, I'm done with the hat. You can have it. Oh, no. Look at you, man. Looks like you done had an accident all over yourself. They make diapers for that sort of stuff. I mean, you got problems, we'll help you. Oh, look at you.
I'm going to kick your ass at WrestleMania.
You're going to show me what you're going to do at WrestleMania.
At WrestleMania.
Then show me what you're going to do at WrestleMania. Come on. Right here. You throw a punch and I swear I will knock the hell out of you. You ain't gonna do nothing, are you? Just like I thought. But I bet you stand there thinking that you're clever for not playing my games. You look ridiculous. And as clever as you think you are, Well, I think you're something else.
Now what?
I'm not touching you. I'm not touching you.
Oh my God.
This is ridiculous.
Are you done? You piece of garbage. You want me?
You know what?
You want me?
You know what? See, in the world that I come from, in the world that we come from, there's people who talk about it, and then there's people who be about it. WrestleMania 21. Let me give you a little preview of what's going to happen to you.
The FU symbol.
They put an FU on JBL.
Well, John Cena called out JBL tonight, and the WWE champion didn't want to go.
No, bro. JBL's a smart champion. JBL is picking his spots, and his spot is 10 days at WrestleMania. Mark my words, Cole. Cena may have punked out the champ tonight, but at WrestleMania, JBL is going to bring the fight to John Cena. I'm telling you.